With scissors, that's how Nigella does it. Yeah, but not too small.
Laura's had all three doses in the arm.
Mm-hmm.
It hurt, didn't it?
The third one did.
Yeah.
Nice, yeah.
But I just think it's really important that she had it done, because that, along with cervical screening, is going to really reduce your chance of ever getting cervical cancer. Most of the girls in your class had it done, didn't they?
We were all, like, kind of scared to get it because we all hate needles and everything. But once it was done, everyone was fine and, yeah.
Did you get a red arm?
No.
No? I remember there was a lot of complaining. There was a, oh, I can't lift my arm up. That was an excuse not to hang the washing out. Oh, I can't lift my arm.
I'm not really looking forward to the injection, but I'm okay with it because it helps protect me.
Doing now?
Yeah.
I want my child to have it to protect her from that virus if it ever comes into contact with her as she gets older, so enough to know that it's something that I will definitely give to my child.
And a lot of my friends, or a lot of people, you know, like my peers, so people the same age as me, they don't grasp the concept that it's not going to make you sick, it's not going to make you get ill from. I think they can't get their head around that, but that's only a few of them. Yeah. People are prepared to go and get, you know, tattoos or whatever. What's one little shot?
So the immunisation works by presenting a protein to the body that the body sees as if it's the HPV virus. The body responds through its immune system developing antibodies, and then memory through its immune system. The HPV vaccine is three separate doses over a six-month period of time. You need the course of three to boost your immunity to really strong levels to give it long-lasting protection. The importance of the second, and particularly the third dose, is that the body's memory is created for the virus, and then you have a very long-term memory, so that even when you're exposed to the virus later in life, your body will remember and fight it vigorously. Hence the importance of the later doses.
There you go, that was just a child consult, no charge, thanks.
Cool. Thank you.
The importance of having the HPV vaccine earlier in life, prior to being sexually active, is so that we have protection on board in our own system for when we face the virus. If we choose to delay and have the vaccine later in life, it really depends whether we've already been exposed to the HPV virus or not. We may have left it too late.
I find it interesting because I'll be at Laura's netball or something, and the mums will be talking about the vaccine, and some of them just don't understand why it's given at 12, and they think because it's given at 12, that gives girls license to be promiscuous, but it's not about that at all. It's given at 12 because that's time and it's most effective. And I mean, obviously, most of those girls won't have sex for a long, long time, but if they get the vaccine at 12, it means that they've got time to develop the antibodies by the time they do come into contact with it later.
My daughter, she's 15 years of age. She is part of the HPV immunisation program. She's a little knowledge bag, you know. She's decided, yes, she will take the... She decided she was going to take that. Even though I said she needed to take it, she said she'd research it first. So she makes sure that it is going to be right for her. She's awesome. She's a teenager, but she's awesome. But I'm very proud of her for doing that.
The most common parental concern, appropriately, is this vaccine safe? And we have a large amount of international experience now on this vaccine. It's been used widely in the world, and it continues to be monitored closely. The one concern we always have with this vaccine and any other vaccine or medication is allergic reactions, and the very rare chance of an immediate severe allergic reaction, which could happen in the order of 1 to 2 per million doses. It's very rare. And it's important, though, that when anyone's been vaccinated, to wait for at least 10 to 20 minutes afterwards to check they're okay, because this is treatable and manageable, and it's important to watch for it.
An important thing to understand about the HPV vaccine is that it helps to protect against the main types of HPV that are likely to lead on to cause cervical cancer, but there are other types of the virus that may also cause cervical cancer. So what's very important is that young women understand that even though they've had the vaccine at a young age, when they reach adulthood, age 20 onwards, it's still very important that they have regular cervical smears throughout their adult life.
I wish the HPV vaccination had been around when I was younger. It's a preventable disease. Women do not need to die or go through what I've been through nowadays. Anyone that has a young daughter should seriously consider the option of having vaccination.